What's up, people? And today we just got another movie trailer, and this is the Power Ranger movie trailer. So the last Power Ranger trailer was the teaser trailer, and finally we got the official trailer one. So I will be hoping to get more stuff, and let's watch the trailer, shall we?
None of us really know each other.
We're all screw-ups.
But somehow... we were all in the same place at the same time when Billy found those coins.
Guys, check out how we glow.
I'm blue.
No, I'm black.
What?
I am.
No, you're not.
You're so weird.
We're strong.
I'm saying we're strong. The answer to what is happening to you is here.
That's Bryan Cranston.
Are the Power Rangers.
Did I just hear you say we're Power Rangers?
Is this some kind of joke? We're talking to a wall.
I was kind of expecting a little more.
So where were you last night?
Me and four kids found a spaceship buried underground. I'm pretty sure I'm a superhero.
Cool. Ping in that cup.
Power Rangers were a legion of warriors. You must become those warriors.
It's the hologram, like a video game.
It's a strong ass hologram,
not a video game.
Oh, God.
You were born for this.
I will destroy everything.
She is pure evil. This is your time.
Few things I really need to say first. The rapping part is the one that really pulls me away from the movie. As what it is the same effect that it did with for me in the Assassin's Creed trailer. Once you have Kanye West rapping, and it really took me away from the movie. And once you have the stupid rapping part, they really really took me out of the movie. But I understand why there's a rapping part, because the target audience for the movie is kind of like a bit of a teenager or more of a younger adult like me. I'm more of considered more of the younger adults, more during the early 20s or early 30s. I'm more of a late 20s, so I can understand why there's a rapping part within that. But the problem with the rapping part is that it doesn't feel like it doesn't feel that serious. But I know that they are not going to be too serious because they are not aiming for older audience and what not. So it really got me out of it, to be really 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 honest. But I will have to say that a few things that I'm really really surprised and I'm really glad to see was Bryan Cranston as the mentor of the Power Rangers. I'm really really happy to see that. It kills me. I already know that Bryan Cranston is already in the movie, but I did not know that how Bryan Cranston as the mentor of Power Ranger, how are they going to portray him. But once we saw that in this trailer, I have a bit of a mixed feelings with this one. So I'm going to do my analysis right now. Well, nothing to see here because it's just high school and suburban. Luckily, it's not in the city. It's more of a suburban, to be honest.
None of us really know each other.
Okay, they don't know each other. Okay, this is the one thing that I'm not saying that I'm racist, but because I'm really, really, really used to the Blue Ranger being the white guy, the nerdy guy, and then the Black Ranger being the black student. But the way they change it, as in the black nerdy guy to be the Blue Ranger, it somehow shifted a bit off for me, because I'm really, really used to the original five Power Rangers. So the way they shifted this is a bit off for me, to be honest. Yeah, the reason why they say they are screw-ups because in the previous trailer that they did mention that they are more of a what do you say, they are they all went into a detention, something like that, so they are all screw-ups. It kind of makes sense, to be honest. But what I don't understand is that why Billy the nerd guy is in detention? How often do you see the nerd guy being in detention? They are all in the same place at the same time. It means that they came here before. Now this is their second visit. Found those coins. Means the first time they found the coin. Then the second time means that they have to revisit, and then they found the base, then they met Zordon. Yeah, so this is the second time when they started to enhance their power? That's what I can say. Maybe this is the second visit, so that's why they have color more enhanced. Okay, this scene really questioned me. Is it like, are they supposed to purposely make the Blue Ranger black so that the Black Ranger can tell the black jokes? Is this why they cast the Blue Ranger as the black in order to have this black joke? I'm just curious, to be honest. Okay, that guy has some maps. The red coin is right in the corner. The red coin is right in the corner. Yada 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 yada. Okay, like I mentioned in my first trailer reaction, that when they receive the coin, they are stronger, they are faster, and they enhance their human ability. But what happens if they have the Power Rangers suit on? Will they enhance their ability even more, or just merely provide them more protection? Because without the armor, their human ability is already enhanced. My question is that when they wear the suit, does it continue to enhance their ability even more, even further, or just add protections? That's what I'm curious about.
The answer to what is happening to...
Okay, this is where I love in this trailer. Hearing the voice of Bryan Cranston in this part really makes it... Wow, I was like... Every part of me just now... I felt excited, to be honest, because finally we get the glimpse or a second that we can finally hear how does Bryan Cranston is being portrayed in this movie.
Is here. You five are the Power Rangers.
Did I just hear you say we're Power Rangers?
Is this some kind of joke? We're talking to a wall.
I was kind of expecting a little more.
So where were you last night? Me and four kids found a spaceship buried underground. I'm pretty sure I'm a superhero.
Cool. Pee in that cup.
Power Rangers.
Why is that even in the trailer? I don't understand the purpose of that peeing in the cup in the trailer. Is that supposed to be like Trinity is sick or some sort of problem, so that's why we need her for a medical checkup? What does that have to do with this trailer? I don't understand why. It doesn't solve anything at all.
For a legion of warriors, you must become those warriors.
It's just a hologram, like a video game.
That's a strong-ass hologram.
Not a video game.
They say that those are holograms. But they... No, even though those are not holograms, but... In that moment, is that a training? Let's look back for a while. It looks like a hologram. It does really look like a hologram. But at the same time, they can punch. So are they the real creatures or not? Maybe we'll check it out when they show more of this clay monster at the end.
A strong-ass hologram.
Not a video game.
Elizabeth Banks. Now you see there, those are genuinely rock. Those are genuinely rock. Whereas just now the one in the previous, those are holograms. So I can say that the one in the earlier version, those are really training session like this. These are more like training sessions for them to train up their movement, those kind of things. Whereas in that in the back is where the invasion starts. That is what I think, at least. So they say that these are holograms, but yet they punch, they give a real punch there. Okay.
That's a strong ass hologram.
Okay, in this part, I think that she is in this disguise. This is more of a, how do you say, a jewelry shop. Let's look at the background. Oh, everything here looks very glassy, and then she wears very, very classy. I can say this is more like a jewelry shop, but why is she in a jewelry shop? Oh, okay. Okay, think of one thing. I can think of one thing, maybe. This is just a speculation. She was trying to retrieve her green coin or green power for her staff. So that's why she is in this jewelry shop, you can say that. So that's why she, now that she already has her powers, now she can raid rise an army. I'm sorry, I really cannot stand the rapping part. Okay, that scene looks badass. This scene as well. At first I was a bit on a mixed side with this suit, but now that I look at these suits, it's delicious, man. This scene is really good. Surprised that they can open their mask, their helmet mask into something like that, as in like if it has kind of a Iron Man helmet, as in you can still open and see the mask. But my concern is that because they are in this Megazords, will people see through the window? I mean, as the outsiders, will they see through the window so that they know the identity of the Power Rangers? Oh, saber-tooth tiger. Let's have a closer look. Wow. Yeah, they do look very mechanical. Come to think of it, they don't look that large, like, they don't look that big in a poster. Because by this size and this building, I can give you top that the height of the saber-tooth tiger is about three stories high, because based on the trailer they are like a hell tall. Oh, Tyrannosaurus! Oh yeah, this is the part where they go a bit too far. They shouldn't have shown Golda. I'm suspecting that this is Golda as the big bad monster. I really hope not. I wanted this to be like in the second or in the third trailer, something like that, but this is way too soon to show. This is what worries me a lot. Because you've already shown that this is the big monster that the Power Rangers have to fight. What other stuff that you are going to show me in the second and the third trailer? That is what worries me. You already shown this a lot to me already.
That's a lot of gold. This is your destiny.
Who's the guy? I mean, who is the guy that the Red Ranger is saving? His father or someone else? But I kind of got the feeling that this is his father. I may be wrong. Or maybe it's not. Maybe it's just ordinary people. Just to show that these Rangers are the good people trying to save the public, the victims of the town. Oh, I have to say one thing, that I'm glad that this take place in a suburban place. It's not in the big city place where a lot of Power Rangers usually take place in cities and whatnot, but this looks really nice in terms of suburban, where you start start your skill in a small area, then slowly getting larger. Maybe we'll get a more Power Ranger in the sequel where it will take place in city. This is what I really, really like about, based on this picture. I mean, this trailer. Guns. Wow, hold on! Can you imagine how big this guy is? Like I said, look at this picture right here. Let's say this blue building right here is about 2 stories high or 3 story high. Most probably it's 2 story high based on this car. Then his knee is about the 2 story high. Or 3 story high at least, or maximum. This guy can be as big as 6 stories. No, not 6 stories, more like 7 to 8 stories. That is the maximum I can give it. So this monster, I mean, Power Rangers are not that big. But based on this giant monster, Golda, I can say it looks like Golda. You have some space, I mean, the face there looks like a giant monkey or whatever. And this pterodactyl, it looks really, really, really small. Look at that, it's so small! Maybe this guy is bigger than the Megazord itself. Okay, I don't know what is this about. I really don't know what this is about, but it's really, really interesting to see. Whoa! That's a cool shot. Okay, this is a really cool shot. Thankfully that these Megazords are small, so that when they transform together, they are big as wow. But where's the pterodactyl? You only see 4 of them. Maybe the pterodactyl is already down. But Golda looks badass. Whoa, hold on. The Tyrannosaurus has machine guns? Wait, the pterodactyl is on the... Wait. This is a pterodactyl, and then this is Tyrannosaurus. What's going on here? They are not transforming, but they are shooting. So something is going on here.
This is your time.
Okay, this looks badass. Ooh, yeah. Okay, I want to see this shot again. Oh, not too far. This scene looks like they are about the same size. Really, they look about the same size. But the texture and the quality. Look at that. It looks really, really different. To be honest. This is the Triceratops, and this is the Saber-tooth Tiger. This is the Tyrannosaurus. Pterodactyl. Where's the Megalodon? Let me see the Megalodon.
This is your time.
Okay, think about it, like I said, how big are these guys? This is, let's say, like the top of a building, like the second or the third, 3 stories high. This is his knee, this is his thigh. So these guys are not that big, so I can say like they are about 7 or 8 stories high. But while transforming, they are about 7 or 8 story high. That's what I think they are. But that looks really, really good. Wow, okay, there's a lot to digest. after with the analysis, like I said, that they are somehow give too much of the trailer. But since this is trailer one, and then we will be getting the movie on March, maybe we'll get like trailer 2 and trailer 3. Trailer 2 and trailer 3, then we'll get some spot TV spots or whatsoever, then we'll get a movie. So this is what I'm guessing. I think that in the second trailer or third trailer, there's nothing much else to see. Because in this trailer only, they already gave a lot of information. But which, like I said, I was hoping that Golda and this Megazord stuff will be shown in the second trailer and the third trailer to tease us even more. But just this trailer, they gave a bit too much, in my humble opinion. So this is my trailer reaction analysis for Power Rangers Trailer 1, and I'll see you all next time.